Welcome back from that short commercial break. You're still watching Salon Talk with your girl, Samara Heath, aka Wild and Free. Feel free to go down to our social media platform, that is Urban Television Uganda. And of course, leave there a comment or a question that you would want to ask these lovely artists in the building today. Don't forget, we are at Spectra Salon in Bukolobi. They have three branches, one in Kabalagala, one in Machinde, and one in Bukolobi. Come down, grab yourself a package. You're going to be looking amazing by the end of it all. Before we went for the commercial break, we were still getting to know you guys and talking about, you know, the connection between the earthly world and the spiritual world. And we've talked about dress codes, and Kajambi has said it's not really oh, this is something that I would want to put on, or this is something that I would want, like I would not want. So Lyrical Michael, do you think dress code does matter, or it does not, depending on what you're doing?
It really does. In this perspective, I'll start by showing you God approaches people in the language they understand, you know. He was God. Then he had to dress like we humans, in human form, so we could, and he came. Now, if he's gonna send me, a hip-hop artist, to preach to people that speak all hip-hop,
so all hip hop,
all hip hop.
I'm lying.
Hip hop. Let's take it. Now, if I show up in a suit like I'm on a wedding, those guys are not gonna listen to me. Let's take it. Now, I am using the language they understand, so that they can get the gospel. Netashitegeza nti no, I'm gonna compromise. Kati, I love when Paul says, I become all things to all people so that I could win some. Now, basically that means, singa nzijane nga nchimanyi nti mwete mwaga la mviri. Nenga teni no kujoku banamu. Nenda, techinzi buwalida kuteka kwa hudi kumutwe. Then I come. So when he told me we're going to be on Urban TV, I said, oh, Urban, okay, that's cool. I'm gonna be Lyrical Michael.
Like Urban, yeah.
But if this was gonna be in Masaka. No, please don't say that.
No,
I would show up in a suit or a kanzu bishop.
Hey, so
Echirunji, when you're in this Christian faith, mukama kuwa moyo wa magezi. Oshitegeera, si kubeera onga gwe tuluwoza
nga gwe evolinda Yesu yabakuteka muzi idea mutwe.
Anti checho, the Holy Spirit omoyo moyo wa magezi. So if you have the Spirit, chitegeza anti, you can discern wano chino chetagisa wano chetagisa. Angira Kajambi ya wagamenti, no one told him don't wear a certain way. I grew up at Miracle Center. Twine now group here, worship team, Gabajita Mafuta. Now, these Mafuta ladies were originally hawkers. Is that the right?
Yeah, Abatembe.
Bamalaya. Prostitutes. Bebatembe. Yeah, cut the when they were in church, Boba ina a very interesting story. Nga bagamba bayambalanga mini ne makeup ne byonna bye bakolanga for the devil. Kati balina zambala bikube makeup for God.
Ne mini bazambala.
Kati when they used to come to church, it's kati zija. Nga bas besa ze bro. Oshitegeera. Kati nga bayimba. Kati muzaite yabagoba. Oshitegeera. Nga baweereza. Kati the people at church had a problem with that. Gwinga mafuta weba ku stage tubanga bali kushoya
yazi shiba
wawinino aji
zani nenda za mwogende kati weba kuruba wogamba hao liwa mchala ya mwogende misama deo
na ye with time abachala bachuka, they are married. Alice is now Pastor Alice. So it's a journey. As a process, by no more to Vagenda, Balunga, Miampola, and Pola. Who knows? Nanga news of Kulikara.
True that. Omutuaka by the Aizokolo was over Oliver Rasta of Deria. Come on,
Nanga Chirunji, Kuba, Katins. My ministry is inner city. Okay. So actually nze njagala nya aba rasta boy.
Bobo yagala oba wuli
nze. That's my ministry.
Yeah.
Era most of the times pastors take me to crusades, not to stand kusawe mu. Nze sija na ku crusade waguru. Fetu baita itamu eri.
Kachoga mgea ne muno nyabo katonda we.
That's
kuni study we yagamba bange loga asiba bo bange.
A study taka baka wanuti babi. Abalimba.
Abalimba. Wow. So now I want us to jump into the next question, which would be, you have talked about dressing, you know, like fitting according to the crowd that you want to listen to you. Yeah. So what do you have to talk, what do you have to say about certain pastors like Pastor Bugembe, whereby they perform in bars? We have had Exodus, who's a gospel artist, who
bars by and all the, that. You, we need to respect that guy. He paved the way for urban gospel. Shout out Exodus, you are a real fighter. Yeah, I needed to give him his flowers.
Of course, big up to you, Exodus,
Bishop.
I know,
right?
Do I need to, you know?
No, it's fine. It's fine. This is a very sensitive question, and you would need a lot of wisdom when tackling it. But this is what I would say. Number one, like I said, that salvation is a journey, and everyone is at a different stage. Number two, our callings and assignments are different. You understand? And just like Paul says, let he that eateth judge not he that eateth not, and let he that eateth not judge he not he that eateth. But here's the thing. Why I had to mention that scripture is, unless God comes and talks to me, probably tonight, but right now as we speak, you are not going to find me in a bar. Right? I just need to say that clear. But why I had to bring the other scripture, that doesn't give me ground to judge the one that is going to, the bar.
Going to the bar.
Because I do not know what the assignment with God is. Because you see, God is very interesting in how he assigns people. You know, there can be a calling that all of us are pastors. But trust me, if you go and listen to, let me say, my pastor, Pastor Grace, you listen to Pastor Bugembe, Pastor Bujingo, Pastor Robert Kayanja, they're all preaching from the same holy book. But you'll start to realize that their messages have distinctions. You can't say that. Yeah. Apostle Grace sounds like Pastor Bugembe.
They all have their different ways.
Yet they're both preachers. Yeah. So for me, that's what I would say. And of course, it also takes me to the other scripture that we mentioned about, of in whatever we do, even in our liberties and freedoms, not to stumble the brethren. So because for me, the other thing I look at, a man can, for example, be in a bar and is drinking, and you know, as surprising as it might be, there is no scripture in the Bible against drinking.
Yeah.
So all scriptures that concern wine, they only rebuke getting drunk. But at one point, Paul is writing to Timothy and is telling him it's good to take a little wine for his health. So, and disclaimer, by the way, I do not drink, not even
at
the little.
All.
I do not drink.
Because
at all.
I was going to be like, Jesus.
Yeah,
in a bar, and there is no way you're going to sit in a bar. Even those that don't drink, they get drunk because they have seen someone else get drunk.
So I do not drink. Now, my not drinking, my earlier years in the world, I used to drink. But my not drinking, I don't even sit down with someone and tell them, you know, scripture tells you that if you drink, you're going to go to hell. My not drinking. Yeah. Is a personal conviction according to the journey I've worked with God and where I am in life. You might be drinking because for you are sober, you know, you'll control it. There is a young man, about Denga, it has been his struggle. Nagambola role model and nayanywa. He'll start drinking, but what that drinking will lead him to, it will cause him to do other things. And the Bible says you'll be also accountable for his sin. So that would be my response.
Wow. Now, this also comes back to the question of pastors that go out of their way just to attach themselves to certain audiences. We have had the likes of Pastor Bujingo, whereby Azina's Nobuntu who stage just to attract the local youth. Do you think that when it comes to spreading the gospel or spreading the word of God, do you think a person should do that or just go away where they move, go to and people look for you?
I personally think Techina Vziwukwa. Oh, but don't you mind, if Abraham was around today, he would be probably driving one of the best cars.
Me, I would say Abraham would be having a lot of mistresses. Because he had one wife, Sarah, who gave birth after the angels came and blessed her, right?
Oh my God.
It should be, if he was right now in this modern world, he would be having a lot of mistresses.
Right, one here, he was a man of faith.
He was a man of faith, so but we have also had kings that have done that.
Having the mistress was not really because he wanted to.
But because the wife could not give
birth. His wife, yali, actually, Oyo Haga Yava, from thoughts Zamukazwa Abraham, they were not Abraham's ideas initially. And actually that baby was not recognized as the official let me rephrase it. The Bible yali written ngabakozesa quills and ink.
Papyrus papers. They used to use papyrus.
Now modern core. Bible yada. They used to have scrolls.
Aren't scrolls was kolanga kuzi papyrus? Like that is how they used to make scrolls.
The scrolls.
The ones you wrap.
If the Bible was written in 2024, probably Apostle Paul could be on TikTok saying, "Hey yo, what's up?" Now. and we could have the gospel according to Mark could be on the internet and we could log into the gospel according to Matthew.
Yeah, because I've also seen modern Jesus.
The Psalms of the modern Jesus. Some of these things they are for the devil. Chejo tuwa nyo devil credit. Nei nange situ kiride. Chejo papa cheya gamindi. Olusi tetugenda kujawa no kwefu lava deputy Jesus to gaya mwana teka kato yo chali. No, if he is not against us, he is with us, and we are here for the gospel. Sit your bishop.
That's right.
Thank you, sir.
Moving on, I want to know. You've talked about you're not searching, but she's there. We should wait, and she's there.
And
so
the
is your wife?
Her
is
baby.
Your... Oh, what am I?
I see you.
Oh, I'm feeling the tears. Oh my God. Anyway,
when you seek and you find, the next part is to take before God. And
I'm sorry, no more. Baby, are you hearing?
At will lead a sip blessing yoka and favor.
Oh,
stay here. Kati.
When I can go from Bogana to Ramurunja, Mary.
But Nanga Nessun's a baby.
Ogana woman, why were I getting up from Namuza? Good, how excited I am. Man, and I told him, Bozevio. Oh, they are wedding.
What's
going on?
Bishop.
But we are coming actually.
We need to break that spirit.
We are coming actually to the end of the show. The reason why I brought it back was I wanted to ask, would you marry a person who is not in your religion? Like, could you marry someone who believes in the Catholic? Let me give an example. You're Kajambia, you're a Christian. Are you a born again? You're a born again Christian. And then you fall in love because love is inevitable. You can fall in love with anybody.
Actually, Kajambia. Please give me the honor. Onumusajia yeita Kajambia. So there's a scripture that says the word of God is sharper than a double-edged sword.
Sword.
And katia dabakwe sanga sword zao. Katio no chali ye Kajambia. So you don't even have to ask if he's a born again.
Would you marry someone who's not in your religion? whether they're Muslim, whether they're what, but you fell in love, or you're going to gala.
Meanwhile,
that's what I
can't. Okay, number one, point of correction. I do not subscribe to a religion.
You don't subscribe?
Yeah.
Subscribe? Or to Netflix?
To a religion. And you know, sometimes we talk to Mulida Enjiri. What about to Gamba? Now, for me, this was the religion in which I was born, all my forefathers. And I always ask them, which religion was Jesus?
Sure that. Actually, that's a question.
Yeah.
So religions were made by men for various reasons. Because you'll start to, when we start from the Roman Empire, and then we start to see how, when you look Martin Luther, how they broke off and all that. That's a whole discussion for another day. So I don't subscribe to religion. So being born again is not a religion. It's having faith in the Son of God. So now the question would be, can I marry someone with whom we don't share the same beliefs?
Okay.
We don't subscribe to the same faith. For me, it's an absolute no. There is no debate about it. There is nothing. The Bible says, how can two walk together except they agree? And then it also says, Paul also says in, I think it's 2 Corinthians, it tells us to not unequally be yoked. So for me, the point here is, let me tell you, even if it's not relationships, even if it's with your friend and you're walking, if both of you don't agree on whatever you're going to do, it can never work out.
It can never work,
so two cannot work together if they don't agree. So for example, if I believe that salvation is through the faith of the Son of God, he died, shed his blood at the cross on the cross at Calvary, and through believing in him I receive eternal life, and then maybe for you believe that by facing a certain direction or looking at a certain idol, for you that's where you get your redemption from, just by that we're not agreeing. Trust me, but the clashes are going to be many. So for me, it's an absolute no.
Absolute no. Yeah. What would it be for you? Would it be a yes or a no? Like right now, since you're currently in a relationship.
It's a no.
It's a no. So your current person believes in the same things you do?
She does. Actually, she shanders. Do you know what we call shanda?
Please explain more.
I was speaking in tongues. Do you speak in
tongues? Imagine those days in school when everybody wanted to speak in tongues and they'd be blessed. I'm like, so the Holy Spirit doesn't now exist? So they don't know that Samara also needs, it's an empty vessel, needs to be, you know? Like, you know, when it comes to Christianity, things are really, really complicated, like both of you have said. Like he has said, you cannot be there. You do not know what God has said to a particular person. So now, before we actually end, this is a question. This is not part of my producer's questions, but this is my question. So right now, like I said, I read the book of Revelation so much, like in and out, in and out, in and out. And there are trumpets. Were there 12 trumpets? So right now, the lake, the Euphrates River has dried up, which is a sign in the Revelation. Do you guys believe, as gospel people, are we in the end times? Because if you're to look about the signs, there are only 4 signs left to the coming of Jesus. Do you think we are in the end times, depending, because you follow scriptures, you follow what God has left behind. So do you feel like we are in the end days? Because someone out there, and we really need some advice to that, if at all we are.
Yeah. Like I said, she's a woman of scripture.
I know, right?
Yeah. We are, for anyone that reads the signs, we are definitely in the end times.
Yeah.
And
give me the jibbles. just give me the shakes.
I think for me, from her, I'm realizing the seed is there, but normally even the company we're around, because honestly, if everyone you hang around with only talks about the other side.
Yeah.
But anyway, and I think if we are definitely living in the end times, it actually should be one of the most exciting things. Yeah. Like for
what do you mean?
Yeah,
so for a Christian, maybe. Yeah,
it should be one of the most exciting things to hear that we are in the end times. So we are definitely in the end times, no question about that. Though there's one thing I'll also leave out for us, because Jesus kept stressing that no one will know the day and the hour.
Yes, yes.
And at some point he says that what some people might see as the end might may not be just the beginning of the end.
Yeah.
But trust me, we've already started the journey of the end times. And
yes,
personally, definitely. I'm overly excited.
Check out, but I'm going to see you're so clean.
Something very interesting about the end times. The other day, walogaya janangamba. So the Bible says, one day in heaven is a thousand.
This side.
Actually, in Psalms, it says one day is like a thousand. But in First Peter, it says one day is like 1,000 years.
Yeah, cut some people, bachibuza uzecho nevaloza and cut we are in 2000 after the death. So maybe it's just like 2 days in heaven. So end time tenatuka.
So
chitegi raikati.
So antubabuza uza mpura.
Kati bachibuza uza nenga nze nganze I feel nekadona gamandi aja kuda. The Bible says he will come go mubi muchiro. Like a thief in the night. So you have to be ready. Oh my God. So we have to always be ready. We have to keep our faith walk ready. Ila chuvula wakati wayogede kuchoga andi gwe olusi faith fedingam kati kajambia was saying do my kati olusi the less time you spend with truth the easier it is to believe lies. Kati gwe olinyo surrounded by untruth.
An earthly world.
Because I'm thinking you also need girlfriends like LM, like Kajam.
Yeah. That is why I'm going to get your numbers right after here.
Actually, this gentleman, yeah. This gentleman is a bishop.
Chidu cha bishop cho.
All
right, yeah. Guys.
So we are not the kind of guys that are going to come to you in Dugambe, repent, ogena kufa, encha. No. Yeah, but we make you fall in love with this guy that loves you.
Okay.
Most people don't even know how to love.
True that.
Yeah.
True that. Thank you guys so much for coming through. It was such a lovely conversation. It is so good to go back into the roots. So good to go back into the roots. But like I've told you guys before, and I've always stressed this, you may see me skeptical or somehow, but you know, I watch a lot of movies, and movies come from ideas, and ideas come from above. Right? So majority of these movies all have the same concept. The world is ending, like a world is. I've talked about the beginning of the end. Now in movies, majority of the times beginning. And also the Bible talks about whereby those that are in Christ will be taken and then those will be left. Which looks like these movies that people are producing, these people are disappearing. Anyways, thank you so much for tuning in to Urban TV. You've been watching Saloon Talk with your girl Sobara Hits. But before I sign out, of course, my lovely guests have to give us their social media handles where people should find you. Atigobanga mbiori bishopu. Bishop buktu kusanga wamu. Ngatuangala yesu kusanga wa.
Yeah, so once again, this is Kajambia. My social media handles, I'm on X, I'm on Instagram, I'm on Facebook and TikTok. It's all at Kajambia Music. So, ojakunsanga my social media handles. But I also, like I said earlier, I fellowship with Fanero.
Alright, thank you so much. And of course, Lyrical Michael.
Lyrical Michael, LYRICO. Michael, MYCAL. I'm everywhere. Kati waliwe mpia bajita Vero. Na yoje ndi. Njidi tujitwala ba. Boli wangu. Yeah, I fellowship with Miracle Center, Rubaga, Pastor Robert Kayanja. But I also serve with a very good friend of mine, Bamuita Apostle, over Pastor Dirain, a House of Love. Kembaba zibuliru. Akusa tu then sana mba ku Miracle Center. Kati people like Kajambia, But Papa Vange, you actually need someone in your life that, you can say mwana chigani sabida.
You can reset your spiritual life.
Some of you guys were chigana mugena mabala. I don't know nyo mwenge, no kumbadi ba mwenge tegumala obizi. It just postpones it. Kastagu kugwa kongera chitandika. But when you need some, weta gomuntu yo, katichiringa people who, people abanywa, the groups of people that take alcohol, wagamba, baba yo ne soba gaya abavuga.
True, True. There's always that one person who doesn't drink.
To drive them and mean the guy everyone is drunk, the guy has to stay sober. So in your life, you need that you need to have that guy in your circle.
Yeah.
Someone that is always gonna watch over you spiritually. Fetuva itaba pastor, ba papa, ba mama. It could begin with a Christian friend or find a church.
All right. Thank you so much, guys, for coming. This was such a very beneficial conversation for me and for the people who have been watching. Thank you, guys, for tuning in to the show.
Can you pray for the people?
Eh,
for once. But not. Just close your show. Close the show with a prayer.
Hey, okay.
Yes.
Let us humble ourselves and we pray.
I see you.
Dear Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the gift of life. We thank you for the gift of salvation. Even as we have gathered today, King of Glory, bless our ideas, bless our conversation, bless the show. And I thank you for everybody that is in this building. Thank you so much for everything you've done. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
See you guys next week, same time, same place. Bye.